Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to the Netflix live-action Avatar The Last Airbender Season 1 Episode 3, titled Omashu. News of a traitor puts the trio at odds in Omashu, where a mechanist and rebels with a charming leader muddle their plans to protect the Earth Kingdom. So this is the one that revealed just how out of order some of these events were going to be when I was reading the synopsises, because this is obviously Jet, the episode, the band of rebels with a charming leader, but it's also the Northern Air Temple, by the sounds of it, with the Mechanist, which, why would he be in Omashu? Everything. I've got no idea who the traitor may be, because they don't exactly have any allies for them to be betrayed by. Yeah, so this is going to be weird. Plus, there's the fact that they're in Omashu, but their first point of contact isn't going to be seeing King Bumi. Like, because that's pretty much the only thing that happened in Omashu. So, are they turning this into, like, the Earth capital? Because it wasn't. It very much wasn't. So, anyway, let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Started in the Fire Kingdom. Hope. Question: how do the people in the Fire Kingdom know the Avatar's back? Like, that was one thing that was kept from them. This whole thing was not a thing in the original. I wonder if this is one of the things that they're allegedly bringing into canon in the next Avatar project. Because they did say there were a couple things in this that they liked enough to want to make canon. At least, that's what I've heard. Yeah, what did you think? Did you really think that was gonna work? haven't really done much after what your grandfather did, so. Really? You didn't recognize the Crown Princess? Where the hell did he get that fire from? Because he didn't seem to generate it or anything. Just seemed to erupt at their feet. The Avatar has returned. I wonder how Zhao would react to being called not someone of importance, well, someone of no importance. This is different. It's a much sharper. At least it was in the cartoon. It was a much sharper wrist snap. Yes, Katara. Tap into your anger. And that is your most... Well, I guess so. But I will be looking over your shoulder every time you write a message. But, gotta wonder, given the fact that no one could recognize the Crown Princess, I'm guessing they still don't know why Zuko was banished and everything, which means we may still get the story from the storm. No Bonzo Pip and Padalopsicopolis. I wonder, are we going to take a ride down the mail chute in this? Yeah, it was part showboard. So, is that jet? 'Cause I'm just going based on the fact that based on the conversation between him and Katara. I'm guessing he's meant to be Jet. There's the Mechanist. Okay, I know what's going on now. So Jet and his band of rebels are staging Fire Nation attacks in Omashu. Okay. Yes, but also I'm supplying the Fire Nation. If he's anything like his cartoon counterpart. You've seen Omashu many times. You're best friends with the king. His reaction to that. Okay, we've got Mei and Ty Lee already. Yeah, he's definitely got the plans for the airships. We've been leading missions like this for ages. Is he actually a Fire Nation, or is he a freedom fighter that has a flame mechanism? Even just seeing the pauldrons, you could tell it was Jet. Gotta wonder, does he really need to worry about updrafts and that if he's got an actual airbender with him? Yeah, okay, no, it's not. Flame mechanisms. That is very interesting. A very interesting utilization of the hook swords. Smellaby, I forget what the big one's name is. I forget what the name is as well. And there's Longshot. Pipsqueak. Yeah, that's the big one. No. He does have a very technical mind for someone who comes from a culture that technically none of the cultures have real technical input, so other than the Fire Nation, so could have said that about an Earthbender, an Airbender, or a Water Nation, Water Tribe. Yeah, what did happen to the rest of the people in Jet's town? Like, it wasn't just the five of them up in the trees in the cartoon. found Jet's cloak. Her getting incinerated right before my eyes. I know this is a 8-episode show and they've got to streamline the training as quick as possible, but that didn't really flow very well. Remember the sunrise. I could do it. No, that would be Ba Sing Se. Yes. Of course it was G. Just sort of passing information back and forth. That is not the comeback you think it is. You've given him a bomb-laden thing to take into the palace. So this is the showdown we should have gotten in Kyoshi Village. Yeah, he's just as lithe and agile as you are when you don't use bending. I guess we're going up the mail system. I thought it was going to flip the table. Cabbages! And water whip. I thought she was just gonna knock the thing out of his hand, but. Say hello to the Dragon of the West. What are you going to do without Iroh? was he being detained? He was... I guess they have a, American school system way of dealing with things. If you're involved in a fight, no matter if you're defending yourself or not, you're in trouble. Or, well, you know, Boomy's the king and he's like, hey, there's an airbender. Maybe that's my old friend. Or someone who somehow survived my old friend's culture's destruction. So I would very much like a word with him. But, yeah. Okay, so that was one of the weaker episodes. By that I mean, there's only two other to compare it to. It did have its funny moments, and I do like what they're doing with Zuko, but I've always thought that Jet was a weak episode. And while I did like the Wrestler of Freedom Fighters and that, they didn't really do much in this. So we didn't really get to know much about them. Also, the Northern Air Temple, we don't actually have confirmed 100% that he's working and giving the Fire Nation his ideas and everything. So, like, that's clearly what is happening, but that's because I know that's what's happening. Because there's nothing to confirm, like, he was giving, like, ideas and equipment and everything. So it's going to be interesting. That's probably going to be revealed in the next episode, so don't have to wait too long for that reveal. But Amashu looked good. That is one thing I will say. The visuals are good. Now, yes, most of it is computer generated. And if you actually look, you can see where real ends and where the computer starts. But it doesn't really detract from the spectacle in my eyes, because, like, it looks like the cartoon. They have recreated shot for shot some scenes from the cartoon. They've also been bringing things from future in the story into this, sort of to flesh out the world. Because, like, yeah, what was Azula doing during the whole first season? Like, there were reports about the Avatar's return and everything that obviously made their way to the Fire Kingdom. And, well, we didn't see what her or Ozai was doing. The plot of there being, like, coups within the Fire Nation itself wasn't a thing in the cartoon. But it sort of fleshed out, makes it more realistic. Because, yeah, there would be people against unifying the world under one person's rule through the destruction of every other culture. Like, or you should stand against that. Doesn't mean people do, but, yeah. So, I do say out of the three, it's the weakest. But that's because it's brought in stuff from episodes that I'm not overly fond of. And surprised to see Mei and Ty Lee already with Azula. Because they'd split off from this point. Like, we know that, well, technically Mei hadn't, because it's not until the Fire Nation takes control of Omashu that her family is then put in charge as governor of Omashu, which then leads to her being recruited by Azula again. Totally, no, she had already left and joined the army, not the army, the circus by that point, so I don't know what she's doing there, but it does make more sense that May is there. Interesting. There's no actual credits or anything for the what's it called? Traitors to the Fire Nation, I guess. Because a couple of them looked familiar. I really shouldn't go off of looks, because I do have somewhat of facial blindness, so. There's also no credit for Katara's mum in this either, so. Okay. I guess I'm not going to be able to find that out. Anyway, I'm going to end this one here. I'm very interested to see what they do with Bumi, because I've heard it's disappointing. To be fair, most reports I've heard of this show is that it's disappointing, which I don't agree with just yet, so could be a case of that, but yeah, I'm going to have lowered expectations going into the next episode. But until then, I'll catch you in the next one.